Hi, I'm Michael Chan. Today, we're talking about how to get started with React.js. We're going to build up a simple React app in nothing but a plain HTML page. This is just to get our feet wet. We'll talk a little bit about React and also JSX. Let's get started. First, you'll need an editor. I'll be using Atom. You can get Atom for free at atom.io. We'll make a new file. We'll save it to our desktop as hello-react.html. There it is. We'll generate some HTML boilerplate and a title that says hello-html. Now let's open that up in our browser. I'll be using Chrome. Now that we have this all set up, we need to actually install React. So we're going to go to reactjs.org. Click the big download React button. And what we want is right here, the development version of React. We're just going to copy that, go back over to our editor, and paste it in. We need one other file, the JSX transformer. It's all the way at the bottom here. Copy that as well and do the same. We'll just paste it in. Now we have React installed on our page. We can close this up. Let's get to writing our first component. So first we need a new script tag. Instead of the type being JavaScript, it's going to be JSX. We'll talk more about JSX in a minute. For now, just know that this is the language that we use to template out our components. We're going to create a new variable. I'm going to call this greeting. This will be the name of our component. We'll use React create class to define our component. And we'll give it a spec object. This object is only required to have one function, which is render. React render functions are pretty neat. We can do this now. We'll take our h2 from before and put it right inside our function. Now all we have to do is say return, and put a semicolon at the end. This is all that's required to create a component in React. Now that our component's defined, let's use it. So we'll use a new function called react.render. Now this render function's job is just to render our component somewhere on the document. Here we can use that JSX syntax again to use our component. This time we'll do a left angle bracket, and here write greeting, as we would if it was an HTML element. And the second argument is where we want this to actually go on the document. So we'll say document body. If we go over to our browser, you'll see that we see the same thing. To prove that this is working in React, I'll change this to React. Awesome. It can be very helpful to have a good idea of what JSX is doing for you. Let's go back to our code and comment this out. We're going to write it again, but without JSX this time. So we'll take this whole thing and cut it out. And here, instead, we'll write react.createElement greeting. If we go back to our browser, we can see that everything still works. If we want to make sure that it breaks, we'll say greeting and see that nothing's rendered. This also applies to our component. Let's change that as well. So if we go back up here, we'll comment this out. So here, instead of using JSX in our component, we can use react.createElement. We'll use an h2 like we were before. Now the second argument is an object that has all of the things like classes and IDs and data attributes. We're not using any of those right now. But the third argument is our text inside. So we'll say, hello, no JSX. Now let's not forget, we need to change this back from greeting to greeting. Save that. And everything works as expected. Now, a lot of people get hung up on JSX. They think it's just too weird to have what looks like HTML inside of your functions. At the end of the day, it's just a language extension that allows you to write functions in a way that feels a little bit more familiar. I really like it, and all of the examples that I show you are going to be using it. So let's change those back. So that's how to get started with React. We got React on a plain HTML page, wrote our first component, and got it running. Thank you for watching and playing along. I'm Michael Chan with SitePoint, and I look forward to seeing you next week.